In this video tutorial, I'm going to show you how to rotoscope, which means tracing over a pre-existing footage in a new app called Flip a Clip. Now, this app is a lot like Procreate in a lot of ways and some basic functions, but it's a lot simplified, and it's simpler. So we're going to use it as an intro into rotoscope to see who is successful in rotoscope and who really enjoys it. So the first thing you're gonna do is make sure you download the Flip a Clip app on your Casa iPad. To get the password, you have to go in today's Canvas lesson. Then you're going to click plus. You're going to name your animation, and I recommend name it something specific. I'm gonna call mine Rotoscope Dancer because I'm gonna be rotoscoping a dancer. We're gonna keep it at 12 frames per second as a YouTube project, and you're gonna create it. Now, throughout this demo video, some ads might pop up on my iPad. That's because we're using the free version. We can't use paid versions on the Casa iPads. So this is the basic setup of what it looks like. You're gonna go to the top right-hand corner, and we're going to actually import the video first. So the top three-hand dots, you're gonna click Add Video. You will pick it from your video library, and you will insert a video that you either recorded of someone else, or you'll insert a video that I provided today in the Canvas lesson. For this demo, I'm going to use a video of Miss S. I'm gonna click use. It's going to compress the video, which is gonna make it easier for us to animate. And I can only animate around 5 seconds in Flip a Clip. And that's fine because animating 5 seconds is more than enough. We're going to look at the video and kind of select our favorite 5 seconds. And then I'm gonna stop around here. Okay, great. And then I'm gonna click the check mark. If you are going beyond 5 seconds, Flip a Clip will not allow you to do so. Now notice how my video is a square and it's in a rectangular format. We actually want that because at the end when we export this, Flip a Clip is going to put an annoying watermark on it. But what you can do is you can crop the video in your iPad and that will remove the watermark. So a couple things we wanna set up from the get-go. We're gonna turn off onion skinning by going to the top right-hand corner. So just flip it off. That makes it easier for us to do rotoscope. Then you're gonna go to the bottom right-hand corner and you're going to look at your layers. Now in Flip a Clip, we can only have 3 layers, but for what we're doing for this exercise, you do not need any more. You're gonna go into layer 1. I recommend renaming it drawings. Clicking update. Now, I think it's easier if we reduce the opacity on the first video, the first layer, which is the video. To do that, you're going to go to the percentage, and you're just gonna pull down with your Apple Pencil and see how it's like getting lower and lower. And I'm at 55%. I think that's good. Now I'm gonna go to my drawing layer. Now, the next thing that I'm gonna do is I'm going to look at what I wanna draw with. I'm gonna use the pen tool for this entire thing and the bucket tool, which is just like the fill and color selection. It is not nearly as advanced as Procreate. Like, we don't have a lot of brush options and pressure sensitivity, all that stuff, but it's okay because we're trying to simplify. So you're gonna go into that pen tool, and then you're gonna notice that the line weight is really thick. To undo something, by the way, just tap 2 fingers. Now to change it, just click on it and see this little circle with a dot in it. Pull down to make it smaller and go up with your stylus to make it a lot thicker. I'm gonna pull it down to 1 because honestly, if it's a lot thicker, it's gonna take me forever to make sure I get my details. And then essentially what I'm going to do is I'm going to retrace the image of Miss S. Now this is relatively mindless. Like, I recommend listening to music or a nice podcast, but you really wanna make sure that you're thorough and that you give yourself enough time to do this exercise. I think the power of rotoscope is that it allows you to really focus on fluidity within your animation because you're not brainstorming it by yourself. You don't have to use a ton of mental bandwidth. I'm just gonna retrace it. Only getting the bare essentials of what I need. It does not need to be perfect, especially because this is an intro exercise. And use what you know also about figure drawing and gesture drawing in general, I think it will help you to simplify. Now I want to fill in this shape. To do that, I'm actually going to create a solid object and close the path so that I can fill it in and it will look like a cool negative shape within her pants. To do that, I really have to make sure that I actually do close the path. I did. And I'm going to go back to my tools. I'm going to click on the paint bucket. And now I'm going to change the color. Definitely not to that. I'm going to change it to black. And see this threshold thing that I'm tapping on, the percentages? If I drag my stylus down towards the bottom of the screen, it goes lower. If I go all the way to the top, it's really high. I'm going to go super low, like 4 is fine. And then I'm just going to click on it, and that just fills in that negative shape. It's a really cool feature. Then I'm going to finish up tracing. Like, I'm not even going to put in all the toes. I literally am just getting the bare basics. And then I'm going to call that panel done, and I'm going to go to my next one. Notice how I don't see the previous panel because I don't have onion skinning turned on. So if you're seeing yours, that means most likely you have that turned on. Now, some of the difficulty with this is that you can't always see the actual footage because, the video got compressed and is getting pixelated. That's okay. It's definitely not the end of the world by any means. You will notice the more clothing that's put on the figure, there are more things there is to draw. So really be mindful of whatever you are rotoscoping, that it's relatively simplified. Now I have finished, or at least halfway finished, tracing the dancer and creating the rotoscope. So what I did basically is I added a background color and then I just turned off my layer by just clicking the eyeball right here. Now you can see when I stopped rotoscoping because I flipped through and there it is, right? I stopped. So a couple things, if you wanna change background color, you can just go to the bucket, change the color. I'm at 50% threshold. Say I wanted to change it to this color. I just tap the screen and then it changes the color. So if you wanted to do that, that's really easy. You could do it as you're drawing, or you could also do it at the end, which is what I do. Now the next thing you wanna do is you want to save this in a video format for your iPad. And then the next thing we have to do after that is remove the watermark through a post editing program. It's really not hard. It's just annoying because we're using a free version. So you're gonna go to the top three circles in the top right-hand corner. You're gonna click on it and then you're gonna click make movie. I recommend calling it something descriptive so that you can find it. Call it Rotoscope Dancer. And then I recommend saving it as a GIF. And then you're gonna click make movie. Now the next thing you're gonna do is it's going to save to your camera roll in your iPad. You're gonna go open up wherever iMovie is on your iPad. That already came with your iPad. So as long as you didn't delete any apps, you should have it available to you. It's a great post editing program. You're gonna click on it. And what you're gonna see first is a screen with a bunch of different boxes. And mine has a lot because I use iMovie a lot to edit tutorials. You're gonna click the plus icon. You're gonna click movie. And then essentially what you're gonna do is you're gonna look for wherever your rotoscope is, and there's mine. And then I'm gonna click create movie. Now this is the easiest way I know to remove a watermark. So you're going to click on this, the box down here in the timeline where your actual rotoscope is. Like if you play it through, you can see it. So all you need to do for that is click on it, and then on your actual display screen where it's showing your rotoscope, you're gonna click the plus magnifying, and it says pinch to zoom, and you're just gonna pinch that so it literally removes the actual watermark out of the frame. Really easy, no big deal. And now my dancer is filling more of the frame, which is even better to begin with. Then you're gonna click done. You're gonna name it again. I recommend naming it something descriptive, like removed watermark from rotoscope dancer. And then you're gonna click done. And you're going to export it. So I'm gonna click that share icon. I just click save video. I save it to my photo library. And from there, just like with the walk cycle, you're going to import it into your Google Slides. If it's too big, you can also import it into a YouTube channel, which you have a YouTube channel with your Casa Gmail address, and then insert it into the link into your Google Slide portfolio if that doesn't work.